this is Lynn from wisconsingarden.com. And since we've had almost 8 inches of rain since we planted our flower bed, we are reseeding our flower bed again. I'm afraid most of the seeds simply washed away. They should be pretty someplace, but they're not in our garden. A few are, but not enough, not nearly enough. So my husband took me to the store today, and lo and behold, we found our giant zinnias that we always loved. The giants of California, they're called, two different varieties, and then also a peppermint stick one that should be just gorgeous. So I've taken all of my containers, my envelopes, put them all together like I usually do, mix them all up so they're nice variety there. I think I'll take my gloves off. And we've scratched the surface, so they'll make contact with the soil, but this time we're gonna put straw down just to make sure they don't wash away, because we're expected to have rain again today and tomorrow, and then I think we get one day off and then some more.
Oh, rain. When you need it, you don't get it. And when you get it, you don't need it.
You don't need as much.
But I will say this, our rain barrels sure are full.
They are, and we're not complaining because we don't have the flooding that's going on in so many parts of the Midwest, and we don't have the drought that's going on in the West, so we're not complaining. Well, you can see that some of them have come up. Those little roundish ones, those are nasturtiums. And I think those are the bachelor buttons coming up. And then you can see a few of the cosmos are trying. They're trying really hard. So we left what we could, that we could identify, and we will sprinkle these zinnias in between the other parts. Now these are very tall, so they will get taller than most of these that are in here, except for the cosmos.
Well, you always like the giant zinnias in this area anyhow when you come out of the kitchen.
I do. They're so bright and happy.
And somehow we forgot to buy some this year.
I don't think we could find them when we were on our initial quest.
So do you feel like Johnny Appleseed?
I do.
Lenny Appleseed?
Lenny Zinnia.
Lenny Zinnia seeds?
Of course, today everyone is cutting their grass because it's been growing wonderfully. But if you wait too long into the day, it starts raining again or it gets really cold and foggy.
Isn't it amazing the fog we've had this year?
Yep.
That's because Lake Michigan is still so cold.
What a cold winter will do for a person.
Who knows? It may be till next summer until we warm up. Hope not.
Global warming?
Yeah, global warming.
Okay. Now I'm going to just kind of push them down a little bit. Just to make sure there's good contact. What are you doing there?
Sorry that one of your viewers thought I was trying to electrocute you with your hair.
We all have our styles.
Thank goodness. It'd be kind of boring if everybody looked the same.
Yes, it would. Bagged straw. So it's regular straw, but it's been chopped up a little bit and put in a bag. so it's much easier to get in your car without making your whole car a wreck. And that way you can haul it to wherever you want. And I don't want to totally bury the plants that are already here, so I'm just putting it on lightly. And as the season goes, it'll just start composting right into the ground. It'll also help keep the weeds down.
Well, you're also going to be adding straw to all the vegetable beds too, and the strawberries. We're able to bring in 30 bags of straw today. Hopefully that'll be enough. And they're not real heavy, are they?
No, not at all.
And the nice thing about the package is if you don't get to it all at one time, if it does rain, it's protected, so it's ready when you are.
Well, remember, this was the kind we had one winter that we were using for insulation around our greenhouse.
Yep.
And the following spring, it was still wonderful, and we were able to use it in our garden.
And in fall, if need be, you just rake it off to the side. Suppose you could compost it into the soil. That looks pretty good. Now all you have to do is sprinkle it.
Yeah, get it. Water it in so that it stabilizes, and then we should be set for tonight when it starts raining again.
Yeah. Now you're going to do these other two little areas over here?
Yes, I will.
And replace all those seeds. It's like watering a new lawn.
Mm-hmm. And you can see how it moves when the water hits it. That's exactly why we're watering it in first, so that once the rain gets here, it should be settled in already, and it won't all end up in the low spot.
Well, plus you have to water the seeds so they can start to germinate.
And it's warm enough for them to do that.
Now, how often would you recommend for somebody who's never started seeds before, once they get their seeds in, how often would you recommend they water?
At least once a day, depending if you've had rain or not. And sometimes if they're in direct sun all day long and the soil looks like it's dry, you should do it again. So twice a day if it's hot and dry. Until they establish. Now, those nasturtiums that you see up, these ones right here, those would be fine with every couple of days, now that they're big. But since they're in with these new seeds, they'll just get more every day till everybody gets big.
Remember the strawberry container we got my mom?
Mm-hmm.
Now, she lived in Las Vegas, so obviously it was really hot. So she had to water them several times a day.
Yes, she did. In this lower bed, I'm going to be putting this catch fly. They're very, very fine seeds, and they get to be about 18 inches tall. So I'm just sprinkling them in here. I'm patting them down.
You're going to put a little straw over those too?
Yep.
I wonder what the new electric Harleys are going to sound like. They won't sound like potato, potato, potato.
I think that's what they sound like. Whoosh.
That'll be different. Probably be the most silent Harley reunion ever experienced.
Kind of like the Jetsons.
Remember when we went downtown and saw the 100th?
Yeah.
That was incredible.
That
was. Tens of thousands of motorcycles all over the city. It was wonderful.
Here, again, a variety of little daisies that'll be only under 8 inches tall. So that's okay because I have some petunias in here and some marigolds, so it'll look pretty.
So these are what kind of daisies?
They're just a daisy mix, it said.
Let's see the picture ones.
Okay.
Pretty.
Again, very, very tiny seeds. Rather like the moss roses I planted in here originally that never came up.
The Ross Moses?
The Ross Moses.
Sorry about that. I have a different way of speaking sometimes.
Yes, you do.
Call it Rickyisms.
Let me just take out these weeds here. Okay, that's a weed. There's straw over here.
A great thing about straw is it not only retains moisture in the ground, but in this case, hopefully helps the seed from washing away, because when it rains really hard, the water just comes pouring off of our sidewalk here. And who knows where those other seeds end up? I'm sure the birds had a feast.
Possibly. I'll just even this out so it all looks like we planned it to be this way.
And it's also a nice way to keep the weeds down, too, if you have a thick enough layer.
There we go. Just water them in.
Now, if we had more grass clippings, because I'm notorious for eliminating patches of grass, you could have perhaps used that as a mulch.
Yes, I could have. But even with all the rain and all the cutting that we've done and all the nice clippings, we just still don't have enough. Some of our viewers have looked at these green poles and wondered what they were for. These are actually for swimming, but since we don't have a pool, we use them as a hose guard. So underneath here, he's got a pole. And so people don't bump in and hurt themselves, or to make them more visible, we just cut those swimming tubes and use them as a kind of an awareness factor so people don't bump into them and hurt themselves.
So instead of having a tube fight, we put them to good use.
It hasn't stopped us from having a tube fight.
I know. How about pillow fights?
No, that's for your lady at the rummage sale.
Oh, that's right.
Well, we'll hope that this time the seeds will come up where we've planted them so we can enjoy them. And when they do, we'll let you see them. Hopefully you've enjoyed this video. Please give us a thumbs up. And we'd love to hear from you. I've been enjoying all your comments and the way people have been sharing what's happening in their gardens. And we'd love to have you subscribe and be part of our garden family. Bye for now.
Yeah, I'm ready for a shower.
There. I could turn this hose on you.
I just bet you could. I think we'd have an interesting fight for the hose. Somehow I think we'd both lose.
You'd be refreshed.
That's true.